Elimination. So we need to now be able to do the second step of formulation. So before I do that, now what will happen at the second step of formulation is that I look at the second, I start from the second row, second column now, and I look at all the elements in the second column below, the second row and below. So I get 0.001 minus 2.75. So what that means, I have to take the absolute value of 0.001 and the absolute of minus 2.75, see which one is greater, and based on that, I have to do the switch. So what that means is that, so if I start my second step of forward elimination, I got to take 0.001, absolute value of that, and minus 2.75, the absolute value of that, and that turns out the maximum is 2.75. So what that means is I'm at the second step of forward elimination. I'm at the second step of forward elimination, and it so happens that the third row, second column, has the maximum element. So what that means is that I have to switch rows 2 and 3. So I have to switch rows 2 and 3. So what that means is that if I want to write down this in the matrix form, I get 20, 15, 10. So I'm switching rows 1, 2, and 3. That does not make any changes to the solution vector, as some people may believe. So you get 0, minus 2.75, 0.5. So this is where the switching is taking place. 0, minus 0.001, 8.5. The next one is 45. This one is minus 2.25. And this one is 8.501. So that's how the switching of the rows is taking place, because we have moved the maximum absolute element which we had to the pivot location here. So now we're going to use this row and this element here to make this to be zero in my second step of forward elimination. So, but before I conduct any elimination, I have to see whether I need to switch any rows. So let's go ahead and do that and see that what do we get from here. So it's very important that you realize that all the calculations which I'm showing to you, that they are all done with 5 significant digits with chopping. Till now, we didn't have to worry about whether we are using 5 significant digits with chopping, because all the numbers which we got were with less than or equal to 5 significant digits because of the multiplication and the multipliers we had. But that won't be the case now, because what I need to do is, in order to make the element to be zero, I'll have to divide by minus 2.75 and multiply by 0.001. So the multiplier is going to be 0.001 divided by 2.75. That's going to be my multiplier. And this multiplier here, is it minus? Yes, minus 2.75. So that will be the multiplier. So the multiplier is turning out to be minus 0.0003636363. Remember, I'm taking 5 significant digits with chopping, so that's the number which I'm going to write down. I'm not going to write down anything more than that or less than that. And I need to take the last equation, which is 0. So the second equation is 0, minus 2.75, 0.5, and the right-hand side is what? Minus 2.25, and I got to multiply by this number right here. And this is what I get. I get 0.0009998. And here I get minus 0.0001812. And the last number, which is the right-hand side number, is 0.00081816. So remember, all these calculations are being done with 5 significant digits with chopping. So that's what you're going to get. Now you're going to take this result which you got and subtract it from the third row. The third row is 0, 0.001, 8.5, 8.501. And we're going to subtract this right here. So we'll have 0.009998, then minus 0.00018182, and then 0.0008186. Seems to be a lot of numbers we are writing down here, but we have to follow the protocol of 5 significant digits with chopping, so we have no recourse to that. So if we subtract this, you get 0, and then you get 0 here. Now somebody say, hey, this is not 0, but algorithmically I have to put 0 there because that is supposed to be 0. So even if I put the number which I'm actually going to get within the 5 significant digits chopping, it will be treated as 0 when I apply my batch substitution algorithm. So no need to figure that one out. And in fact, it's not even figured out in the algorithm itself, because it's soon to be 0. No need to waste time, computational time, to do that. Now here, when I do this, I get 8.5001, 8182. And this last one here, the writing side is 8.5001, 8184. 8.5001. So let me write this down again here. I get 8.5001, 8184. But we know that we can only take 5 significant digits with chopping, so I can only take these 5 digits, and I can take only these 5 digits here. So this number here becomes 8.5001, and this number here becomes 8.5001. So again, all the calculations have to be done with 5 significant digits with chopping, so that's what I get here. So if I look at what do I get at the end of the second step of forward elimination, this is what I get. I get x1, x2, x3 here. So if I look at that, I get 20, 15, 10, 0, minus 2.75, 0.5. That stays the same. And then 0, 0, 8.5, 0, 0, 1. Then 45, minus 2.25, and 8.5001. So that's what I get at the end of the second step of forward elimination. The second step of forward elimination end. At the end of the forward elimination, second step of forward elimination, that's what I get. But since I have 3 equations, 3 unknowns, I'll have only 2 steps of forward elimination. That's the end of all the forward elimination steps. Now I need to conduct back substitution steps. So that's the end of this segment.